The man, the artist, the designer behind what is known as the Happy Show, coming to the Museum of Vancouver, Stefan Sagmeister. Welcome.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much.
Fascinating idea. You talk about what makes you happy. Everybody mm-hmm. kind of dials in. You've done a lot of research on this. Mm-hmm. How do you first define the notion of happiness?
Well, I think that the one definition that I came across that was the most helpful to me is to look at it from a length of time point of view. So there is very short happinesses, like a moment of bliss or possibly even an orgasm, or like, you know, very short things. Then there is longer stuff, like mid-length things, like lying on the couch with the paper and the dog, satisfaction or well-being. And then there is very, very long stuff, like lifelong things, like finding the stuff that I'm good for in life. Really, you know, is the whole, goes through my entire life. And these three things, even though they're all under this big umbrella terminology of happiness, really have nothing to do with each other. But it helps to define it, really.
Your definition is good, and I know happiness is so subjective. I could say your accent makes me very happy. I love the way you speak, sir. And the visuals from this exhibition, mm-hmm. taking a look at this, I think it's a fascinating experiment. And then it got me thinking, okay, what are the triggers that make me happy in life? How much research went into putting together the visual spectacle that people will see?
Quite a bit. I basically designed the show as a project that would force me to do the research, because I know if I wouldn't have the project, I wouldn't do the research. And so I talked to many, many, many scientists, many psychologists. We had a sort of an official scientific advisor for the whole show, just to make sure that things are correct. And then, of course, as designers, it's very much in our goal or what we do to take an incredible amount of information and present it in some sort of way that hopefully is delightful and maybe even helpful to people.
And you know, when you have your tips on what makes you happy, let's list off some of the simple things that kind of stand out that we could overlook that stand out and make the day different. Where would you start?
Well, what works for me, and I would say that that's true for the whole show, it's a very personal look, because I'm not the real expert on happiness. I'm the expert, the world's best expert on my own happiness. So I can say what works for me. One thing that really works for me is super simple in the morning, that I make my bed. It just puts this break in between the nighttime and the daytime. So like getting ready, this whatever it takes me, 45 seconds.
Making the bed's one, and I know you talk about the other idea, and this is the debate, being active versus being still. Mm-hmm. What do you find provides more value when it comes to the idea of happiness?
Probably both. I found that, meaning I did a lot of experiments on myself, I found that 20 minutes of exercise actually makes a bigger difference in my day than 40 minutes of meditation, which I was super surprised at. I would have thought it would be the other way around. And so I do every day. I do 20 minutes of exercise. Here, of course, it's so fantastic. I ran along the seawall in the morning, and I've actually can say, not yesterday, the day before yesterday, I had a proper moment of bliss right here in Vancouver, including shivers running down my spine. The sun was coming up. It was, you know, around 6 in the morning, like just really spectacular.
It's been a good way, a week on that tip. And then finally, the idea of ending your day. What's a good way you like to cap things off?
Well, what really, really works for me is that I have a little notebook right next to my bed. And as the last thing that I do, just before I put the alarm clock on, is I write down three things that worked for me that day. It can be small things, can be large things, and there is really good scientific evidence out there of how this works and why this works and that it works. And it's, again, it's a thing that takes me a minute, but I sleep in with a positive thought. I can avoid the negativity bias that the bad stuff that happened in my day always has a tendency to go to the foreground. But for me, it just seems a very efficient way to do something.
It's a good way to download. And want to quickly throw out a photo or two. You mentioned the bike in the exhibition. Mm-hmm. And Al, I heard you talking to me earlier. If we have a quick photo we can showcase. This is opening up, and it's going to be here in the Museum of Vancouver for a few months, yeah?
Absolutely, yes. I think it's a 3.5 month exhibition.
And there it is. And if you keep riding your bike, my overall level of satisfaction, that you get words that kind of come with the inspiration, correct?
Basically, it says doing the things that I set out to do increases my overall level of satisfaction, meaning that If I have an idea, oh, I should do this, or I should do that, and I don't act on it, I collect these little pieces of residue that ultimately will form into some sort of ball of discontent in my brain. And if I actually act on them, it really does improve my life.
Interesting idea, Stefan. Congrats on the exhibition. You can check it out for yourself starting this weekend. Again, Museum of Vancouver.